Hi, and welcome to the 2-Minute Guru. My name is Daniel Bogdanoff, and today we're going to look at the difference between AC and DC coupling mode on your oscilloscope. So here I'm hooked up to a square wave with a 5-volt offset. I'm going to go ahead and move my trigger level up so we can see that. And if I want to see the signal that has an offset, maybe I'm looking at ripple on a power rail, or maybe I am, it's a serial bus that has a DC plus positive or negative vertical offset, and I don't care so much about that DC offset, I just want to see what's going on that signal. There's a couple ways I can look at that. So the first thing I can do is I can just move my signal down and adjust my scaling. But the greater that offset and the more I have to do that, it's going to affect my triggering, it's going to affect my signal quality, and my measurements aren't going to be as good. And it's also just going to be a lot more difficult to handle on the scope. So what you can do instead is go into AC coupling mode. So I'm going to select channel 1 and turn my coupling to AC. And then I'm going to reset my channel offset and my trigger. And now my scope has filtered out the DC component of that signal. Essentially what AC coupling does is it puts a high pass filter in sequence with your signal path. So all you have to do is focus on and analyze the AC component of your signal. It's worth noting that your triggering system could also have a AC coupling mode. Now this coupling applies just to your trigger circuitry. So maybe I'm having a hard time getting a trigger because of some low frequency noise and I'm just not triggering stably. I can turn on AC coupling just to my trigger system. So you can do AC or DC coupling both on your channel and your trigger mode. Maybe you do DC coupling on your channel, AC coupling on your trigger, then you're able to get a stable trigger and do the analysis you want. Thank you so much for watching this week's episode of the 2-Minute Guru. Remember, we're releasing new videos every Tuesday, so hit the subscribe button below. And also, you can go check out our Facebook page. And if you have any topics that you'd like me to cover, put them in the comments below, or you can hit me up on Twitter at @Keysight_Daniel and give me some suggestions or feedback there. Thank you for watching. I will see you next week.